Hare Krishna. We are our greatest hope and our greatest horror. There is a constant duality within us. Like Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, the story of Stevenson, where he talks about the same person sometimes acting good and sometimes acting evil. So like that, there is something within us which is positive, which is noble, which is selfless, which is service oriented. And there is something within us which is ignoble, which is selfish, which is exploitative, which is evil. And both of these are present within us. And thus, we can sometimes do things that are wonderful, that are inspiring for us, inspiring for others. And sometimes there are things, we may do things which are scary, which will make us aghast, which will make others aghast. So, this implies that we are our hope and we are our horror. We can create a positive future for ourselves, or we can create a hellish future for ourselves. The Bhagavad-Gita points to this in 6.5 when it states, Uddharedatmanatmanam natmanam avasadayet atmaivayatmano bandhur atmaivaripuratmanaha. It says, elevate yourself with yourself and don't degrade yourself. You are your friend and you are your enemy. So Krishna is telling us, actually, to elevate, that it is our responsibility to elevate ourselves. Atma, the word can be used to refer to mind, it can also use to refer to soul. So we have to elevate ourselves, it's our responsibility. We can't wait in the future for something mysterious to happen that will transform us and suddenly we'll become better human beings. Yes, even if something like that happens, but unless we take that initiative, take that help, we will not be able to change ourselves. Ultimately, we are not the greatest anything. It is God, Krishna, who is the greatest. But even God can't help those who do not want to be helped. Because we all have free will and Krishna doesn't ever take away our free will. So, unless we express through our desires, through our actions, that we want to be helped, Krishna will not intervene. And thus, for us, the change has to begin with us. We have to desire to change ourselves. And then Krishna is there to help us, to empower us, to change ourselves in powerful ways. So, if we have fallen at the bottom of a well, we have to hold on to the rope. And then Krishna will pull us out. So, that determination to rise up, to hold on to the thing that will raise us up, that is something which we have to have. And this understanding that we have to take responsibility for our life is foundational for any transformation. And that's what the Bhagavad Gita informs and that's what the Bhagavad Gita inspires. By understanding the Gita's vision, Arjun takes responsibility even amidst the perplexity that he is caught in. And thus, he creates a brighter future for himself. And so can we, if we recognize that we need to empower the side within us which is uplifting, which is noble, and we need to disempower the side which is ignoble, which is degrading. When we thus become responsible for elevating our higher, for empowering our higher side and disempowering our lower side, then the empowerment coming from Krishna will enable us to curb our lower side, even if it is very strong. And the empowerment coming from Krishna will enable us to strengthen our higher side, even if it is presently weak. So, the transformational potency from the divine will transform us when we learn to take responsibility and cooperate. Thank you. Hare Krishna.